I told her that this is kind of necessary for us, okay, because to just have you online because of the pandemic, right? Okay. And she says that we really follow up the Ciji's steps, right? Okay. And actually, she is very senior. She is very senior in a voluntary. Okay. And the director, Chen Zhi'an, will be also here next year because I invited her. And she said to me that it is 1 year. Okay, and let's take a look at the recap clips about Luo Meizhu. And we were helping the relief, I mean, we just offer our relief in Philippines, okay, after Typhoon Haiyan happened there, right, okay, and this is a clip about that, okay. So Luo Meizhu just participated in online study group before, and let's take one more look at what's going on about Luo Meizhu, okay?
Okay, now you can see this is Master Zheng Yan's teaching. It's about the relief work that the Ciji conducted in Philippines after the Haiyan typhoon. So we offer the cash for relief, and we mobilized the local people to clean their house, and Luo Meizhu was there to provide the best care and love to the recipient. And she said that this is only a 9 years old boy who has to look after the three siblings, and he also do the best, and now we can see like after the Haiyan typhoon, we built the Da'ai village for the victims. So Ciji volunteers is far and wide, so we provide the relief work whenever there is a disaster. This is a very touching story. And the villagers say that I request myself and my family and my children do not touch the bad habit. And now this is another video to saying that in San Chongqing Soho, finally we have the daycare center. And it's the daycare center for the elderly is our main target, main goal that the Ciji Foundation promote nowadays. So next week, please come here to join us because we have the Da'ai TV drama and the main characters. We also have the doctors from Ciji Hospital. So this video, Luo Meizhu is also a documentary volunteer. Now, Luo Meizhu is also a documentary volunteer. And then this is another video. It was September last year during the COVID-19 pandemic. People's life is getting tough. So in this video, it was telling us that Ciji provide the daily necessity to a Catholic nursing home for the elderly. The speaker said that our life is getting tough because of COVID-19 pandemic, but we appreciate Ciji's contribution. Those are the items that we really need. So you spread the love and spread the gratitude. So documentary volunteer Luo Meizhu make this. He devoted herself in international relief. From very young until now, he remained energy. So now, we have to say the password. So we're going to connect to Sanchong. So let's say, I'd like to stay with you because you have a positive energy. Hello, good day, Sister Meizhu. We are so touched. Okay, thank you, everyone. Thank you, Teacher Mayin, and thank you, all the families. Thank you to give me this opportunity to give me the sharing. I get online by 8 o'clock, and I already received so many positive energies. The teamwork at online study group is so touched. I needed to learn. I learned a lot from you. And you did a lot of homework to introduce me, and there are some videos I don't even watch it before. Thank you for your dedication and contribution. So today I'm going to share the topic is to make a self-assessment on the value of my life. I really appreciate this picture with my grandchildren. Actually, I'm just an ordinary housewife with a special affinity. I was into Tzu family, likes to find a light in the darkness. I learned a lot from Master Zheng Yan and masters from Jing's abode. I feel I'm most blessed to hear Dharma teaching and find a mentor like a Master Dharma Zheng Yan. So if I say I made an assessment on my value of the life, it's because I walk into Ciji family. When I had the first grandchildren, I would like to give her a name, and Master Zheng Yan said the grandchildren is your daughter-in-law give the birth to your grandchildren, so you should respect her decision. Who give the name? And in Ciji family, I learned so much from all the Ciji volunteers. I'm not good at writing. So when I make the presentation, Sister Mayin say you need to have some words to describe the pictures. So I'm grateful. Okay, so now let's go to the next slide. And I'm very touched with those pictures. They were our care recipient in old days. I'm very grateful because in the earlier days, I joined the free cleaning service with Master Zheng Yan in the old days. The first picture showing a care recipient Huang Murong. And their family is a low-income family, and because there are some disabled person in the family. I was very touched on those pictures because the clothes that we gave to the care receiving family, we measure their size one by one. So this is what we said, gratitude, respect, and love. I was really inspired by Master Zheng Yan's spiritual cultivation and teaching. So when I follow Master Zheng Yan to Yulin, I witness and Master Zheng Yan comfort the care recipient and provide the relief and give them love. So when I back to Taipei, I always share the story and share what I have learned from Master Zheng Yan to the volunteers in Taipei. So this slide. So this slide, about 4 or 5 years ago, I personal visit the care recipient Huang Murong. I couldn't stop to hold my tears, and so after 40 years, I can still visit Huang Murong in person. Because he received Ciji volunteers' support as a long-term care recipient. And started from the year of 2005, he became a giver who donated $500 every month. Although he passed away last year, but his story is always in my mind. And that was the motivation and the inspiration, and led me to keep working hard on the Bodhisattva pace. And this slide, in 1972, the first commissioner Jingming, Sister Jingming, brought 50 donor members to Jingzi aboard for 3 days. So Ciji is the first of footprint in Taipei was started from Sanchong. So when I realized that it's a very good group, so I make a commitment to myself that I would like to promote and to talk about Ciji for the rest of my life. So start from Sanchong. So start from Sanchong, and at my home, I always hold a gathering. And this is our global, the chief of the global volunteers, Stephen Huang. And because the space is limited and it always crowded on the third floor of my house. So we always seize the opportunity and to hold a tea party or gathering, so to invite more people, hopefully to inspire more people to understand Ciji. I think that Dharma Master Zheng Yan's teaching is very important. So a tea party or a gathering at home is too small. We needed to go out to make an outdoor gathering. So everything, we hold a gathering in the neighborhood. When I walked into the Ciji family, there was only 30,000 members. And Master Zheng Yan said that humanize the Buddhism teachings and bring the Bodhisattva into the world. So we decided to hold a big outdoor gathering to talk about Ciji. So we try to recruit more people to join Ciji. And then we start to bring both members and non-members to Jingzi, or maybe 3 person or 5 person or 10 person. And I always got the car sick, and it become very difficult to get the tickets. Because we think about the the people that we brought them to Jingshebo, they may turn into a Bodhisattva later. So purify the people's mind is the most important thing. And at that time, we don't have our own Jingshebo yet. So we always hold the summer camp in the neighborhood and to borrow the space from the school. So we started to hold a summer camp in the school. So like earlier, we listened to the Li Meilan's sharing. She also started from a very young generation. And then finally, we have our own home.
We finally have our spiritual home, and we finally have our spiritual home. And the first, our spiritual home, we united our heart to build our spiritual home. I was touched and I was in tears. For so many years, we finally have a place where we could gather together to learn the Dharma teachings from Master Chen Yin. On our Santon campus, 90% of decoration were all reused, recycled material. And we truck vinyl floor from Sanxia back to the campus, and the 90% of decoration were from recycled material, because frugal is the and thrifty is our Jingshi tradition. And 90% decorations are used recycled material. Master Zhen Yan came to the Sanchong City campus, and this is a compassionate place where we train bodhisattvas from all over the world. And Master Zhen Yan helped us to build this campus, so we could by our vows and purify this world. We could continuously abide by our vows to follow Master Zhen Yan's footsteps to purify this world. We cherish this place. This place is so magnificent. That is really our great blessings from Master Zhen Yan, and gave us this place where we in the past, before we have this campus, we have to wander everywhere, sometimes renting from places to another places, and we never feel our mind were always wandering around. We never had a place where it could calm our mind down. And finally, after we have this city campus in Sanchong, finally we can calm our mind down, and it's a place where we could gather not only volunteers from Taiwan, and also we could also gather volunteers from all over the world. We could serve a volunteer internationally. We learned so much from volunteers from all over the world because they have totally different experience from what we have in Taiwan. When every time when I take a, every step I step on the campus, I always raise gratefulness in my mind. And this is over 20 years, and there's a crash, airplane crash, aviation accident in Penghu, Taiwan. And I was able to travel to Penghu to help out. And because of the Dharma Master Chen Yan's teaching, I was a normal, ordinary housewife, and I was able to be brave enough to help the diseased and help the suffering in the aviation accident in Penghu. And I heard someone say that someone told me that you should volunteer, ask the survivor not to cry. But in the West, they would encourage us to cry out loud, so to release our emotion. And I told the person, yes, we city volunteer do the same thing too. We offer our shoulder for the survivor and their family to cry on our shoulders to release their emotion and their sorrow. The procedure of the Tiji disaster relief have making progress over the time because of our past experience. And to identify the body part of the deceased, we also use over the time we learn from the experience that we use some items that we found to identify the body of the disease. So we learn just so much knowledge. The more we participate in disaster relief, the more we learn. And there's a flood in Peru. It was my first experience to travel overseas to do disaster relief. I have traveled, someone asked me how many countries that I've traveled to do disaster relief. Peru, Argentina, Brazil, Paraguay, China, Jiangxi province, Hebei, Fujian province, Guangxi, Wuhan, Sichuan, Wenchuan, and Philippines, Thailand, and Laos, People's Republic, and also Nepal, Cambodia. And I also traveled to Kaohsiung for the Morocco typhoon. And I'm very touched. I'm just a normal housewife. I have so many opportunities to travel internationally to conduct international relief, to form a great affinity with people. who are in suffering in the other country. And as the severe earthquake struck Nepal, I went there to do disaster relief too. There's rubbles everywhere and buildings collapse in Nepal, and there are many people are injured. So Shiji Tima team, medical professionals, they will travel to Nepal with us too. Because there's Shiji volunteer and Shiji volunteer and the cash for relief volunteer, they also, Napoleon, they went to a grocery shopping with us. After the severe earthquake, we witnessed the love and kindness from Napoleon's heart. Although they are in deep sorrow, but they still willing to help each other. Although they are very poor, but they are still willing to help the people who are in more dire need. And we assess the disaster. And an older lady who do not want to live anymore because she witnessed her grandson passed away in the earthquake, so she lost hope in her life. We gave her comfort and encouragement. And no matter how far away the disaster scene is, if we could walk there, no matter how far away it is, we have to reach out and to offer our help. And in the disaster relief, international disaster relief, we have to utilize the local resources to help the suffering. And in Indonesia, the poor, the rainy season often flood at the raining area. After they were settled down in the shelter, the tent shelter, but the pouring rain flooded the area of the shelter, and they have to run away. And when they run away, some of them even sleep over because they have to run away to a place with higher altitude. And they got all wet. And Sister Danny and me, we picked up flowers in the wild to decorate for the Buddha Day ceremony. So we guide the suffering to pay respect to Buddha. And this the great enlightened beings in the Nepal, where Buddha was born, we were very touched to see the great enlightened being statued and sitting up on the table. And so the Nepalian, they could pay respect to Buddha. So I was in tears because I was very touched. And this mother gave birth to this little baby during the earthquake, and she asked me to give a name to her son. I gave her son Great Love. The name is Great Love.
And this is the well that she left. Okay. And I always, do this, before I go anywhere. And now let's take a look about the Lotus Sutra according, from Master Zheng Yuan. Okay. And this is the hours that I took my own inventory of my own life, right? Okay. And I have brought more than 1,500 volunteers receiving training courses, right? And now let's take a video. Take a look at the video.
Okay, go.
'm truly grateful as I came in. I saw so many volunteers gathering here. I feel Siji is truly a big family, and it just keeps me warm. I heard them say, "Master, these are the volunteers that I nurtured. My commissioner number is 395. I have truly devoted myself and wholeheartedly followed Master Zheng Yan. I heard Master Zheng Yan's Dharma talk, and I feel grateful. And I have nurtured more than 1,000 Siji volunteers. And I witnessed one seed can create numerous plants, right? And we really create the value of our life. Okay. And we will, just pass on this video to people. And I'm very grateful that we have a kind of good affinities with the Mr. Zheng Yan. So if you have a fast, right, and fast is everything, okay, that creates our Dharma lineage, right, okay? And let's show the Jin submission and pass on the Siji Dharma lineage, right? I'm very grateful that we have so many volunteers that follow up Mr. Zheng's footprints, and we have a great affinities, right? And that sees our every second, every moment in our life, and form good affinities with people, and let's plant good seeds and do good deeds, right? Okay, so we can just spread the love, and we create a blaze, which means that we make people joyous, and we make ourselves joyous, and we can deliver and transform numerous sentient beings, right? Okay. And before we become the Buddha, attain the Buddhahood, and we form good affinities with everyone before this, right? Thank you for giving me the chance, and I'm so grateful. Thank you very much, really. Bless is that we make people joyous, right? So are we joyous to see Meizhu? If yes, right, give her a big hand, right? And actually, we are touched. And you offer a lot of touching stories as an inventory of our own lives, right? And she is a wonderful person. And because, you know, all that she said is all about her stories, like, and this is her way of working on her own Bodhisattva path, right? And if you put yourself in a really, really dignified, like, position, and that you look gorgeous, and that you look good, right? Okay, and actually from the image from the screen, and you see like Meizhu always keeps, you know, her smile, and this is kind of a cultivation as well. So we see at any moment, at any time, and we should do something just like Meizhu. And this is working in the sutra. And probably, you know, I guess like Meizhu, you also smile this way in your family, right? Okay. And you have cultivated this for a long time. And I know us, and as we know that you just, you know, go to the like a good boy as a campaign, right? And relieve the love, okay, I mean relieve like disasters, right? Okay. And if you really like this, and please give her a big hand, right? How old are you? Oh, I'm 72 years old, right? But you look like 27. You are not actually 72, right? Okay. We have a Taipei in Kaohsiung saying that like Meizhu is a great Bodhisattva that shows up all the time in the disaster areas. And now she's telling about her story, about her like experiences. And we really see and witness her inventory of her own life. And this is retouching. And we have Xiaoming from Yunnan, and she's a teacher. And whenever she has any like a piece of time, and she just get online with us. And Liu Chunzhi from Changchun says that she is online with us, although today she is not on duty. And she says that, and we have a Luo Meizhu really nurtured so many Bodhisattvas and volunteers, right? And she is really kind of creating great love and like planting good seeds, right? And this is wonderful. And because, you know, Luo Meizhu also accumulates love and spread love, right? This is what she's doing now. And we have a beer from Canada. And you haven't been with us for a long time. And she says something from YouTube. And she says this is a positive energy from Meizhu. And everywhere, okay, every time we see her, and this is always positive energy. And we have Wen Daizhu from Hualien saying that this is a wonderful sharing from Luo Meizhu, and this is a great thing that we know that Meizhu is a great disciple of Master Zheng Yun working on the Bodhisattva path. Okay, so now I'm always notified that I'm running out of time. Actually, as I saw it online, I find out that we have Ci Guan saying that, and as I see Meizhu, and so many stories came into my mind, right? Okay, and I remember like once, like she was in Thailand with us, right? And that night, Meizhu couldn't find a hair dryer to dry her hair. And I remember that she used the fan, okay? And this is just a story, and I don't know whether Meizhu can still remember it or not, all right? And we didn't, second story, that we didn't have a Jinshi Hall at the center that time. So we invited a lot of volunteers from Thailand and Cambodia to there. And actually, Ci Guan remembers so much, okay, about Meizhu. And this is why she is online with us. And I'm sure that she will just do a great positive feedback next time in words, right? So thank you very much, Luo Meizhu. Thank you so much. Well, you are always young, and you are our role model. Okay, and some people say that the age you start doing Ciji deeds, and you are always that age, right? Well, I started doing Ciji missions as I was 28.